Welcome to the Royal Rumble. On the TV? Hold on. Where's the volume on this? Where's the volume on this TV?
Oh, it's on the bottom. I just don't know which button it is.
That's a good sign.
Yeah.
Yo.
That's why I'm here. I'll make you all proud. I'll give you the hypest commentary I can without Ryan being here.
Best of five.
I feel like a construction worker with a radio. Just best of five, somebody, best of five.
We're already started here?
They're doing butt check.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Now, these are best of five. You may use them, sir.
Okay. Okay.
That's why I gave them to you.
I see how they work now. Okay. I was just confused. I'm gonna scoot this mic a little bit closer.
Mm-mm-mm. Okay, it looks like we're about to start.
Mm-hmm. Glad to see that Butter and the CPU have done their button check.
Did he really do that against us? Oh my god.
He's doing what he's gotta.
Doing what he's gotta do. BRB.
Oh man. It's a plumber battle on stream for the first stream battle of the Bourbon State Gaming Top 16 Invitational. All the competitors that you see today are competitors that have gone to
every
most of the Bourbon State Smash tournaments this year, starting in January, all the way through to the regional double barreled. And
so that was 14 total tournaments this year.
Yes, if you made it into the top 16 on the point system that they used to rank all the players who participated in the tournament, then you got into an invitational, which gives you a chance to win anywhere in the $1,000 pot bonus.
Yeah, all top eight get paid out today. This is given up from Bourbon State leadership up to all the players as a thank you for coming out all year. We're also serving some food today. So first match, we have Butter and Wood.
Yes,
Wood
we have
going with Wario.
The best Luigi in Kentucky and quite possibly the best Wario in Ohio. I just don't really know the entire Ohio scene enough to know if that really is or not.
Wood's usually ranked in like the fourth seeding in Cincinnati, so his performances, RK Legacy, in the last 6 months have been quite impressive. He's taken two overall wins there, and those pool of players are usually almost in top 10 of their entire PR. So Wood's definitely nobody to sleep on. He's got plenty of setups and gaming knowledge here.
Definitely.
So, actually, in the head-to-head between these two players, Butter actually has one lead on a 2-1 for the whole year. So, this could be pretty favorable for either one, depending on their play. But usually, Woods usually goes Game & Watch in this. So, he's using the Wario for the first time against Butter today. Let's see how Butter adjusts to this different strategy.
Mm-hmm. I've actually gotten quite used to seeing some Wario things after playing friendlies with JDB for so long. I've literally played friendlies with him on Tuesday for like 6 hours, and he played Wario, Mario, and a bunch of different characters from the cast. But being able to see how Luigi handles this matchup, and maybe more specifically Butter and how he handles this matchup, this will be interesting.
Mm-hmm. Since I don't know how much bench experience he has, unless of course he's been playing JDB recently.
Right.
Because, in Louisville, we don't really have that much.
That was pretty smart for Wood to hold it
only,
there.
Really, only Marsh from Cincinnati actively plays him in our brackets.
Yes.
You gotta be careful with that. He was telling me earlier if you do the down throw in the bike, you can instantly break the character shield, so there might be something you might see Wood pull off here.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But it's gonna be fishing for that up smash.
Yeah, it looks like Wood was just trying to get past his dash shielding.
Mm-hmm.
All right, smart again. I think Butter's probably going to have to try and mix up his get-up options here.
Ugh. And the teal throw with a forward throw. Doing that gut. Yep. Building up to get the wharf going here.
Mm-hmm. Now, I see that Butter took a little bit of time up on that spawn platform, but I don't know if he'd want to spend too much time, especially because that does give Wario the waft.
After seeing it a little while, if you do down air into warp, it is, mm-hmm. after 50%, it's usually a surefire KO, even from center stage.
Oh, yeah.
So it's, considering he saves warp after he dies, it's kind of a good option to have. So you can sit there and pressure him with rage, then be able to come back with fresh stock and try to pull up with the easy down air combo to finish him off.
Both Wood and Butter expressing both a nice balance of aggressive and patient tactics.
Mm-hmm.
They'll back away whenever they see that their opponent's landing, so that way they can go in with either a jab or either a grab, whichever mm-hmm. one works best. I feel like it'd be best for Luigi to grab, of course, because he gets the most out of it, and then Wario could probably do what he needs to do, dash attack, whatever he needs to do.
Both of them looking for a kill snap here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
He's looking for extended hitbox on that bike. Smart again.
The throw, cover the get up. Pretty good, that down air puts the pressure on and keeps him far away.
Yeah. Oh, fireball gets him off his bike, covers it with the back air. All right, and back air's going to finish the game.
Game one.
Luigi learned that one from his brother.
Gotta stay hydrated in these matches.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, let's see what he counterpicks if they don't just go straight back to
FD. Yeah, looks like Butter's not gonna go back to FD since he can't choose it. He could probably ban it.
He wouldn't. He didn't get to choose anyway.
Yeah.
He just gets to go in real quick.
Right.
You see the character change? I think stage first. Butter's up.
One.
Yes. Oh, Zard.
Mm-hmm.
Zard being the popular pick in Cincinnati. I'm always happy to see it. Where are we going? Dreamland?
Going to Dreamland. This is a pretty good stage for Charizard.
It's also a pretty good stage for him.
Oh yeah. I'd say it's probably going to be more fitted for Luigi, but I can see why. I can see why Wood would want to take Charizard to this stage.
Mm.
I played against Katakiri on this stage as Yoshi, and it was not fun when he was Charizard.
Charizard, yeah. But he's got the top platform for the up throw. I think he's at a high percent. Enough spacing that he could use the platforms for, so.
Mm-hmm.
He's definitely gonna try to build it that percent. Flamethrower. There you go, safe option.
Mm-hmm.
It's just walking. Staying in the walk, giving him more options. Thank you, BB Smash Suits, for that. Well, I guess that was the best punish to get off that quick.
Yeah.
You gotta be careful with the pineapple going in there with the tornado like that.
Oh, he was going for another jab. It doesn't look like he's going to be able to get much out of jab setups with Luigi on Charizard for some reason. Charizard's just
Charizard's
too heavy.
Charizard's poor tail, adding a hitbox completely behind him, and there goes the first stalker Butter. What is that move? Flare Blitz?
Yeah, Flare Blitz.
Mm. Alright. Butter going to fish for the up smash here to finish the stock off the Wood, so Wood isn't going to need extra credit.
Up smash.
That's exactly what he did.
Mm-hmm.
He says my fire is better than your green.
Now that they pretty much reset neutral, Charizard's not going to want to get grabbed this early, because that's going to give Luigi a ton of damage.
30-40% extra damage.
Yeah.
And just as we said it, commentator's curse.
Yep, that's it. At least Charizard has multiple jumps to get out of it, and that almost evened it up. I mean, it's such a powerful move. Put it halfway there.
It is risky, though.
It is.
So you got to be almost guaranteed. So you want to have that experience. Oh, my goodness. Going for it again and missing.
Yeah, I think Charizard's just either too heavy, or he can just get to his jump fast enough to not have anything bad happen to him.
Ooh, and that armor. Put her in the best spot.
Oh, man. Nice platform movement from Luigi.
Alright. You gotta be careful going high, because that up smash is gonna be waiting for him when he comes back down.
It sure will.
Oh! Too bad. Does he have a jab? Jab block? Are you leading something? Or was that just like you didn't want to commit because it put Luigi a little too high?
Yeah, I think you just didn't want to commit. See, that's what happens.
Because it's too high. Yeah, he's going to bounce out of it.
There we go. There's an up smash.
Stealing it real quick from the mist bear. It's 1-1. Pretty even so far. I think we got a ban on Town and City.
That's no surprise.
No. Get rid of the low ceiling.
Switching back to Wario. They're going to Smashville. Trying to keep it neutral.
Are you going back to Wario this time? Okay.
Yes. All right. Once again, combo. Luigi's going to get...
Oh.
Okay. I guess that gets him out of it, but...
Well,
punish from Butter.
You didn't get punished, so...
Yeah.
Right. Not against him on that one. You know, the one thing I like about Wario, not going to sit here and try to jinx Butter any at all, but... You have fun listening to him because he's just doing such weird things all the time.
Recently, I've seen a lot of the community pick up Wario, but and even though I love and respect Wario's aerial movement, I just can't really get a grasp of everything that he does.
No, he's one of those you gotta play him for a little bit to pick up everything.
Yeah.
His small little nuances here and there. So it's really safe when you get up, sit there with your mouth open.
Yeah.
A jump.
All right, that was right, smart right again. Wood was getting a lot out of.
How many characters have these command grabs?
Yeah, Wood was getting a lot out of the command grab in game one. Even though he didn't take game one with Wario, he was still getting a lot out of it.
It was very close, though. It wasn't like bad.
Yeah. Fortunately enough for Wario, he gets his bike back pretty fast.
As soon as it leaves the box of the stage, it's right back in there.
Yeah.
Putting on the pressure here. Edge guard game. Using the wolf to get away. And there's Butter's like, get her.
Oh man, he really wanted it.
Oh. Beating him out.
Odd angle for back air.
Snipes. Oh. I think it's so weird. It's like a weird trip that either just flat out trip or you fall right behind him.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
That was smart. Tech.
Oh, did we tech those?
He got it. He's back in
11.
It.
I still want it. All right.
Yeah.
You know that one.
JDB kept getting me with that the other night.
Recovering low. I don't know if I said JDB or Butter.
Ooh.
Oh, almost.
That was close.
It almost worked. He's like, y'all just up smash this bike. Get out of here.
Wario's heavy enough that even a high percent, if Luigi tried to do jab-jab setup, he would just land on the ground and be able to roll, which is what we just saw. All right.
Well, it's not quite enough. This isn't.
It's still a nice mix-up.
This isn't mid mid-patch Luigi.
Unfortunately, no. Back air.
Unfortunately, no. I think fortunately, yes.
Took a note from his brother's book.
He's trying to get a little more on that command grab like he did in the first stock. I'm just catching on to it. By definitely giving him problems this game.
All right. Oh!
Warf.
Covered the get up
right,
very
right.
Well
two
with that.
2-1. 2-1 wood. Let's see what adjustments Butter's gonna make in game.
Don't be afraid to slide through.
Now the set has moved 2-1 in Wood's favor.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey,
it's me!
It's like Wood's gonna stick. I don't see Butter changing off either. So, where are we going for our fourth game? Lilac. The stage can spell doom for either one of them with the tilts.
Now that Butter's...
I've personally seen the stage take wins away from Wood and Butter, so...
Now both, Butter
they
has
they
to...
both have experienced the tragedy that is Lilac's house.
Oh, my.
Just cruising in space here.
Seems like Butter, now that he's down on the set, he has to power up and switch to Waluigi.
Oh, my God. Has he been in the same outfit the whole time?
Huh?
He been in the same outfit the whole time? Has he been purple?
No, he was green and blue for the
okay,
first
so,
three games.
So yeah, he's going Walla. Yeah. Oh. Making up that percent gap.
Ooh! Ooh. That's a solid read.
Oh, he wanted it bad.
Too heavy.
Heavy just knocked him back too far. Yep.
Yeah.
And he completely blocked with the bite.
Well, if he does the jab, Wario's heavy enough that he can fall and roll fast enough before he can get out the up B.
Alright, Brody's gotta be real smart on the stock and take it quick. I mean, he's got plenty of time, but
yeah.
He doesn't want Butter to get or Wood to get too much extra credit. He's got the warp down now that he just used it. So it's out of the picture for a little while.
Yeah, in this case, it seems like Wood's doing a really good job of actually punishing Butter for approaching with Luigi. Instead of being able to let him grab and do
Luigi things,
a jump cancel up smash, he can just, you know, command grab him.
Whoa! Yep, exactly.
Lilat's not going to let that bike stay on stage, unfortunately.
Nope. It's something I would not risk on this stage.
Oh, I know.
It's because of the tilting. But I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do when you're in the corner here. Yeah, he's not gonna be able to get that up smash the bike's gonna keep him from it each time. Wood going
man.
Deep and making it back. Sometimes I'm just jealous if people can make it back for so deep.
Yeah, I know.
Oh. Completely
oh,
shutting down
man,
Butter's.
It's close.
Butter's game here with the bike. He's gonna go
and
deep.
A two-stock victory for Wood.
So yeah, 3-1 for Wood. Next up on stream, we're gonna have Bracelin and Moose. Bracelin and Moose up next.
Hey, Bracelin, you can't go by Bracelin now. Like, you beat Ethan at JDB.
Hey, Raisins.
Raisins.
Hey, Raisins.
There's another player named Raisin.
I know, you should go by JDB.
You should go by Raisin.
Yeah,
everyone's over here arguing what Raceland's true name is going to be now.
It's going to be JDB.
It's Mayhem.
It's JDB. This is it. This is Moose's shining moment. He gets to fight number one in the state, JDB, as the number one Little Mac in the state.
Yes. Who's actually doing pretty well. I've gone down to a few Tennessee tournaments, gotten first place down there. So he made it in the top 64 at Midwest Midland 5, and a couple top 9 fifth placements here at Coliseum in Lexington. So he's not someone to really sit on. He's a very patient player.
I didn't think JDB would be playing Wario. I didn't think he's... I think he said he wasn't going to do it.
He will. He will. This matchup happened about 2 weeks ago at a practice session, so...
Okay.
I think Moose was prepared for Mario, so let's see what he does against the Wario. All right, going to Smashville Game 1.
So once again, you'll be seeing Wario on stream.
Kentucky, we play more than just this character, I swear.
This is not LOL Farts KY Smash scene. This is, like, Bourbon State Smash. We just happen to have two Warios on stream.
Today. So it's like, oh, we don't see him that much. That's all you see him. It's so weird that the bike can just pretty much ramp the edge of the stage and still roll on.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so bouncy. That option of just bouncing in against the stage, throw Wario back. You've got the bike up there if you want to do some edge guarding.
Mm-hmm.
Chop the jumps, pretty good.
Wario has a lot of good multi-hits that he can use for this as well. I mean,
watch out for that poke.
Yep. He waited enough.
Now, sad thing about Little Mac cannot reach through the platform in Smashville with his up smashes.
Yeah. I'm not sure
if this was Battlefield, he could. He can reach through Battlefield and Lilac. Cannot reach through the Smashville buttons.
One's got a waft, one's got a KO punch. And I guess we're going to find out which one wins here in a moment.
Yeah, well, he's only going to take one trip. So I think the invulnerability with to keep the KO is only about 12 seconds. Yeah, he's going to try to go in and go for this grab and make Moose commit to something to lose that. So he can come back on the ground and face him, because I'm pretty sure...
Ooh.
Oh! Told you, down air.
It's the victory.
Warp. It works. Guaranteed. Cannot get hit by that. Poke, poke. So puts it behind him, so it's kind of a mix-up.
Smart. Oh man.
Oh,
he made it.
What do you know?
Oh, my
Little
goodness.
Little Mac can recover, people.
I was almost certain that was it.
I think JDB was too.
Yeah, I think JDB was about ready for the handshake on that one. That was... Yeah, he waited out that command grab.
Yep. Oof. He's all over him. Max got to finish off this stock quick. Too bad he doesn't have a kill throw. Command grab.
Man.
Yep.
Pretty safe. Think about command grabs. Ooh.
Yep.
See, heard JDB complaining about not having a waft to use.
Yeah, a little bit of waft. But not the walk he needed. There
right.
You go, taking the first stock.
Yep, he's gonna take it for.
Alright, so we're gonna see if Moose can pull this off with range. This is what he's gonna need. He's gonna need some solid hits. Just punch spikes right off the road.
Well, he's racking up damage now.
He's gotta be careful. Let's see if he adjusts the coming off the platform with the command grab.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know what that move is called. Bite?
Yeah, bite. I don't know.
Wario has a dark move for Pokemon.
Right.
It's bad. It's bad.
Ooh!
Oh!
He took it!
He got
it.
Out of the rage! Alright. Moose takes game one.
Moose with the Nostradamus read on number one in the state to take the first game.
Platform worked in his advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Something that happens with Mac. You go on the platform in Smashville and actually be able to pull it off where it works.
Hell of a comeback. He ain't messing with that no more.
All right, so we're pulling out the Waluigi Wario. All right, here we go.
Waluigi Mario?
Mario. Look, Mario Wario. Just flipping one letter upside down.
Yeah.
All right, this is what Moose has practiced for when he was expecting game one, so we're going to see what's going on here.
That was a weird trade.
Well, the jab, the falling neutral of Mac is one frame, so
yeah.
You usually get him out of most chains for the most part.
Yeah.
Usually it's a trade-off. Especially if it's a Mac and a Mac, I've seen that often. They just stand there and punch each other until they fall to the ground.
Yeah.
The other one's picking up with the jab one combo. It's really where Hitstone starts to affect continual chains. JDB's free to do whatever he wants on that type of platform. Moose can make it up to both and land a Cable Punch. He has one, but again, it's a risky combo to do.
Yeah.
Mac has to fully commit and catch his opponent off guard at top platform.
Moose has been playing some of the safest options I've seen him use with Little Mac against Smart.
All right, getting the KO off. He's got to get all that extra credit he can here. Yep. This is the absolute.
Oh,
yep.
Man.
This is what happens.
Mm-hmm.
Mario has pretty good options right there with the cape or the flood. Ready to go.
Racking up damage now.
He's going with a true confirmed.
It's pretty much, yeah, it's pretty much even.
Well, I don't think anything's even with Mac. His Mac can just suffer from, you know,
oh man,
roll. We're going to see an up
there. It is.
Here. Yep. Finish him on top.
That's it.
All right, we got a 1-1. All in there. Alright, I don't expect Moose to switch off of Mac. He does have a core, at least for practicing, but I don't expect him to change. I thought we were gonna go to
Town
there
City.
There's a gentleman in green and some crazy stuff there for a second. Right, Town City. This is I'm thinking about this matchup for Mac in particular. Like, if you can't strike Smashville, if you want to get rid of that platform, Talon City is kind of the better option to keep open because eventually the platforms go away for a short period of time.
You're right.
So the lower ceiling can help, you know, most people are going to kill Mac off the side of the stage as opposed to going straight up. Although we just saw that would be off the top of the stage kill. But some of the platforms lower themselves lower enough. See, like right here, how many times? About 30. See how long it takes for the platforms to come back. Uh-oh. Oh! Too bad. Man. Too bad he was not there. I was like, oh no.
And then he used the KO punch, too.
All right, so it's about, let's see, it was 30. It's about 15 seconds for the platforms to come back. Oh. That was just unfortunate. Oh.
I respect Moose's patience. It's just I feel JDB knows the movement. Yeah.
Well, the thing that JDB's doing is going into right in the neutral space where Mac can't hit him. You're like right inside of him. So you can negate some of the moves, but not all of them. But he puts himself up for the up tilt, but the forward smash and the down smash are going to completely miss when he's right in there like that.
It's an odd time to use Flood, but JDB and I might know what
he's been
doing
it just to push the character back and make him almost reset
neutral. Yeah.
So it's seemingly what he does. He uses it for a lot. Also keep him on the toes and when he's going to... Oh!
Ooh, what a run.
All right, so we got a 2-1 for JDB.
Yeah, JDB's starting the download.
Oh, yeah, he's like, I don't deal with this Mac. I don't deal with this Mac. Get him out of here. Don't want none of this.
He's got the home court advantage here.
This whole arena makes no sense. This is like wrestling, but boxing at the same time.
Right.
And it's all like, you know, that actually is a pretty good option.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I doubt the Mac is ever going to be jumping in that situation, but if he does, he's off stage. Oh. One thing I'm actually enjoying seeing this matchup is JDB is actually going active and fighting. I mean, on this Final Destination setup, you have to.
Yeah.
A lot of times players will just opt and not fight the mech and just sit on platform and wait him out. It's just the limitation the character has. So JDB actively saying he can win. Oh, fireball pushing him just outside of range.
Typically,
I don't know what would have happened if.
Oh my.
If the KO punch had hit, because he would have kicked him and it may have knocked him the other direction.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm gonna go with no. He probably still would have got hit. Mac wouldn't have occurred. Oh. Right. He didn't even follow up with any up there streams, so he didn't want. Gotta finish. He's got the high ceiling, so he's gonna hit him real hard to finish him up.
I think Little Mac has enough time in between the first and second up air to counter.
Oh. Depends on the 1%.
Yeah.
And the risk of Mac, whenever you counter whatever direction he's facing, he's gonna launch forward.
Right.
And he almost cannot. Oh, it was a perfectly good punishable option. Then missed it. That'll probably do it. Okay. Gotta be careful.
Yeah, he waited that one out. Waited out the dash attack.
Mac usually can't wait. Oh.
Oh my! He got him, but it wasn't enough!
Very close. Very close. Oh. We just gotta be careful. Watch out for these throws. Here comes. Oh! Went for the spike.
Almost.
Went for the spike and was trying to call him out if he did the side B. Instead of limiting an option for Mac, taking the side B completely out of the escalation, throwing those random capes out. Again, forcing him to the edge. It's risky.
Oh, man!
Try not to get a little bias here. I was like, hit him, please! Oh! Up smash. Oh, we are one hit away from a death here.
And it's over!
We are 2-2.
It's a 2-2 set!
And here, that headband gone. So, we're good in there.
Mm-hmm.
I figured that would be a no-brainer.
Go on the battlefield.
That'd be interesting. We'll see how much usage platform JDB is going to take advantage of.
Oh, yeah.
And see if, uh-oh. I was like, no, I like this.
It's already over.
It's already over. Looking bad.
GG's.
Well, that's what he did. It's what he did earlier on his second stock in game 2. He just took it in 12 seconds.
Now, JDB...